In this video, I am going to explain what kind of anatomical relationship that psoas has. This is psoas. This is very, very deep muscle. That means this muscle has many myofascial anatomical connection. Basic information. Psoas originates from lumbar spine. Then it crosses hip joint and attaches to lesser trochanter. Lesser trochanter. So basically it moves lumbar spines and hip joint. Okay. First muscle that has relationship with psoas is this muscle. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This is very, very important muscle for tight low back and low back pain. How come? Because this muscle attaches on pelvis, lumbar spines, and rib cage. Ah, that sounds very important, right? It attaches on pelvis, lumbar spines, and rib cage. So, when this muscle gets tight, that can inhibit movement of pelvis, lumbar spines, and rib cage. That can lead to low back pain. Now, psoas is next to quadratus lumborum. Psoas is in front of this muscle. So when psoas gets tight, that can affect quadratus lumborum. Vice versa. When quadratus lumborum gets tight, that can affect psoas. Very important relationship. Next muscle is this one. This one. This is diaphragm. This is not a low back muscle. However, if you follow myofascial connection, there is relationship with psoas. Especially, it has relationship with crura. Crura means leg. So crura is like this. Crura has myofascial connection with psoas. Thus, when psoas gets tight, that can affect diaphragm. When diaphragm is inhibited, that can affect psoas. I am not saying this relationship is found always 100% for psoas problem or breathing problem. I'm just giving you a possibility from a point of view of myofascial connection. But it's good to know. If you know this myofascial connection, you can analyze lumbar spine mechanics, hip joint, with breathing. If somebody has the shallow breathing, maybe that can affect lumbar spines and hip joint. Good to know. Quadratus lumborum and diaphragm. I am going to explain one more muscle. Again, this is psoas. Last muscle I'm gonna explain is this one. This is iliacus. Iliacus. This is famous muscle. With psoas together, these muscles are iliopsoas. Okay. These two muscles can move hip joint. But if you look at its origin carefully, psoas originates from lumbar spine. Iliacus originates from ilium. So these muscles have slightly different functions for core. Okay. Iliacus is more important for pelvic movement and pelvic stability. Psoas is more important for lumbar movement and lumbar stability. Okay. Anyhow, when psoas gets tight, that can affect iliacus. Vice versa, when iliacus gets tight, that may affect psoas. Very important relationship. So in this part, I explained relationship with three muscles. Quadratus lumborum, diaphragm, especially crura. At last, iliacus. These relationship with muscles are important to understand core movement, core stability. For next part, I am going to explain relationship with nervous tissue. Now you see nervous tissue. First nerves I am going to talk about is these nerves. These nerves are called lumbar plexus. Plexus means bundle of nerves. Now, this lumbar plexus passes posterior to psoas and in front of quadratus lumborum. Do you remember these two muscles' relationship? When these two muscles get tight, or either one of them gets tight, that can affect the other muscle, right? Again, lumbar plexus passes between psoas and quadratus lumborum. What happens if both of them or one of them gets tight? That can create impingement for lumbar plexus. Where is lumbar plexus going? It innervates core muscles, genital area, and anterior thigh muscles. So that impingement can create numbness, pain, dysfunction for these areas. That is why lumbar plexus and psoas has relationship. Next nerve is this one. This is femoral nerve. Femoral nerve. This is the biggest nerve from lumbar plexus. Yes, femoral nerve is from lumbar plexus, okay? That runs between psoas and iliacus. Yay, what happens when psoas or iliacus gets tight? That can create impingement for femoral nerve. Where is femoral nerve going? That goes to anterior part of thigh. Thus, impingement of femoral nerve can give a pain, numbness, or dysfunction for quadriceps. Oh my gosh, psoas has so many relationships with muscle and nervous tissue. And I'm gonna give you one tiny introduction with internal organ. Let's say there is kidney in front of psoas, let's say here, not this big, you know, like this. Kidney is very close to psoas. What happens when kidney got dysfunction? That can inhibit psoas. When psoas doesn't move well, that can affect kidney. So, as I said, psoas is very deep muscle. That means psoas has relationship with internal organs. Not only kidney, that can also have relationship with large intestines, duodenum, small intestines. Many internal organs have relationship with psoas. In this video, I explained relationship of psoas. It has so many relationship with muscle, with nervous tissues, and with internal organ. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.